Hello everyone, my name is Sachin Raju. I'm from Assam Don Bosco University, Guwahati. So I'll be talking about a small topic which is known as Faraday's law. So before going into the explanation and statements, I would like to say a few words about the famous scientist Michael Faraday. He was born on the end of 18th century and he was an experimental physicist, also a great chemist. So, as you can see, there are several contributions to the society which was done by Michael Faraday, like the invention of motor, generator, and the transformer. And also, he has invented the laws of electrolysis, which is nothing but a method of separating the bonded elements and compounds by passing an electric current through them. So, there are major and minor contributions to the field of electricity, which is like done by Michael Faraday. So we can move on to the topic. So basically, Faraday's law states that the EMF induced in a circuit is directly proportional to the time rate of change of magnetic flux through the circuit. I hope the statement is clear. So it's nothing but basically when a magnetic flux changes, an EMF is induced in a circuit. EMF, you all know, electromotive force. So due to the change of magnetic flux, there is an electromotive force produced in the circuit. Hello everyone, my name is Sachin Raju. I'm from Assam Don Bosco. Hello everyone, my name is Sachin Raju. I'm from Assam. Hello everyone, my name is Sachin Raju. I'm from Assam Don Bosco University, Guwahati. So I'll be talking about a small topic which is known as Faraday's law. So before going into the explanation and statements, I would like to say a few words about the famous scientist Michael Faraday. He was born on the end of 18th century and he was an experimental physicist, also a great chemist. So as you can see, there are several contributions to the society which was done by Michael Faraday, like the invention of motor, generator, and the transformer. And also he has invent the laws of electrolysis, which is nothing but a method of separating the bonded elements and compounds by passing an electric current through them. So there are major and minor contributions to the field of electricity, which is like done by Michael Faraday. So we can move on to the topic. So basically, Faraday's law states that the EMF induced in a circuit is directly proportional to the time rate of change of magnetic flux through the circuit. I hope the statement is clear. So it's nothing but basically when a magnetic flux changes, an EMF is induced in a circuit. EMF, you all know, electromotive force. So due to the change of magnetic flux, there is an electromotive force produced in the circuit. So mathematically, we have an explanation which is called epsilon is equal to negative of d phi b by dt, which is nothing but the time rate of change of magnetic flux. So here magnetic flux is denoted by phi b. Also, you might be wondering why there is a negative sign on the equation. The negative sign indicates the direction of epsilon, which is nothing but the electromotive force, and hence the direction of current in the closed loop. So from this, the question comes like how we can find the magnetic flux. So to find the magnetic flux, the expression is given by phi b is equal to integral of b dot dA, where b is the magnetic field and dA is the small area we are considering. Also, if the circuit consists of n number of loops and all are of the same area, then an EMF is produced in every loop for the flux phi of b. So we can say the Faraday's law becomes epsilon is equal to negative of n into d phi b by dt. So we can see for the flux phi b, in every loop an EMF is induced. So for n number of loops, there will be n times the EMF produced in one loop. So now we can discuss an example. Assume a loop enclosing an area A which lies in a uniform magnetic field B. So as you can see from the figure, there is a loop of area A and the magnet fields are passing through the loop. So the theta you can see, which is made by the magnetic fields to the loop. Hence, the magnetic flux through the loop is given by phi b is equal to b into a into cos theta. Also, as you know, when the magnet field changes, an EMF is induced, and the EMF is given by epsilon is equal to negative of d by dt of b a cos theta. Also, from the expression of magnetic flux, we can see as the theta changes, the magnetic flux also vary along with it. So we have discussed the statement, the definition, and the example of Faraday's law. So the main thing in Faraday's law is the electromagnetic force produced by the magnetic field. So we can see the ways of inducing an EMF. The first one will be the magnitude of B, which is nothing but the magnetic field, can change with time. So hence there will be an induced EMF. The other method or the other way is an area enclosed by the loop can change with time. So in the previous example we have seen a loop of area A. So if the area changes with time, it can also induce an EMF. The third one is the angle between the magnetic field B and the normal to the loop also can change with time. So these are the ways in which we can induce or produce an EMF. So I'll just conclude everything. So the Faraday's law states that the EMF induced in a circuit is directly proportional to the time rate of change of magnetic field. So when the magnetic field changes, an EMF is produced. So I hope with a small explanation and the diagram and the statement, the Faraday's law is more understandable. So thank you guys, have a good day.
Hello everyone, my name is Ashwin Rajiv. I'm from Assam Don Bosco University.